Sound bars come in variety of shapes, sizes, types, budgets, applications that it often confuses us when we are out there in the market to buy a soundbar and we are flooded with so many options, like something which starts as low as 5 to 10,000 rupees to something which can go up to 2 lakh rupees, right? We are so confused by so many applications. In this particular video, I am going to give you 5 questions that you need to ask yourself so that you come to a conclusion or you find a perfect soundbar for your TV. Hello everyone, my name is Tanmay Mehta, your home technology consultant or home theater wale bhaiya from Touchwood Automations, and I've been designing home cinema experiences since last 8 years, and with that background and the industry experience, I have realized one thing, that we all want to create a great experience, but we do not know what is the right product or what is the right system that we need to put in our hard money into so that it can create that right experience for you in your house. And for that reason, I started this channel wherein I help you with the right tools, with the right knowledge, with the right approach, so that you are in a better place to make wise and correct decisions. So let's get started with the 5 tools or the 5 questions that you need to ask yourself while buying a soundbar. So the very first question that you need to ask yourself is that, are you looking for a soundbar just to get a better output from TV, or are you actually looking to create a surround sound experience in your home? Because with this particular question, you'll be able to understand that if your purpose or your motive is to just amplify the TV sound which is not audible properly, then in that case you can spend less amount of money and buy a regular soundbar which can be as good as, let's say, a Boat Avante soundbar, which is 8 to 10,000 rupees and can still do a good job in your living room or a bedroom application. But at the same time, if your objective or the motive is to create that virtual surround sound experience, then you need to look out for soundbars which can actually create that surround sound experience around you. So that is the first question that you need to ask yourself, that what application are you going to really buy this soundbar for? Is it just to amplify the TV sound, or is it to create a virtual surround sound experience? The second question that you need to ask yourself is that, what sort of room size am I going to install this soundbar in? Like, is it a small room? Is it a medium room? Is it a larger room? Now, based upon your answer, you'll be able to identify the right soundbar which has got the capability to reproduce that kind of power which will suffice your room size. Okay, so always remember that the second question that you need to ask yourself is, what sort of room size am I going to install this soundbar into? The third question that you need to ask yourself is that, what is my TV size that I'm going to actually use the soundbar with? Because if your TV size is 40, 43, 49, these kind of small sizes, then you can go for a smaller size soundbar. But if your TV size is more than 55 or 65 inches, then in that case, you might have to go for a bigger soundbar, which will aesthetically as well, you know, go along with the TV. And along with that, it will also do the job of giving you that kind of audio and video experience together in a harmonic or a little balanced manner. So for that reason, the TV size is very, very important to understand that what sort of soundbar are you going to really buy. Now, the fourth question that you need to ask yourself to buy the right soundbar is, are you going to mount the soundbar? Are you going to just keep it on the table? How is the mounting or the placement of the soundbar going to be? Because this will determine whether you need a soundbar which has got wall mount brackets included, or do you want to spend extra on the mounts, or your option is to just keep it on a shelf. Then in that case, you can buy any soundbar which has got a, you know, flexible placement option. So this particular question will again help you understand the right soundbar, or you can rather segregate the soundbar's options for you. The fifth question that you need to ask yourself is that, what sort of content am I going to watch? For instance, if my TV is smart TV and has got 4K, Dolby Atmos, these kind of applications, and all I'm going to do is connect the HDMI, EARC or ARC port to my soundbar, then I need to be careful while investing in a soundbar, because I need to ensure that my TV and my soundbar can connect via the ARC or ERC cable so that I get the right virtual surround sound experience. Also, what you need to figure out here is that, how many devices are you actually going to connect to your TV or to your soundbar? Because based upon that, you will be able to understand that how many inputs do you need on your soundbar. And also to those of you who are saying that I'm going to connect all the devices to my TV, you need to understand that what sort of output your TV has for audio. Like it can be an RC output or an aux output, which is analog. You can have a digital output in the manner of optical or a Toslink port, or you can have an HDMI ARC or EARC feature. Now, if you're going to analyze all these things and then invest in a soundbar which has got the right inputs for you, then you would be able to use all the features that your TV or your other inputs can offer, and the sound can come in properly to your soundbar. For instance, if you have already got a OLED or a Super Ultra HD TV which has got HDMI EARC, and you're subscribed to Netflix which has got Dolby Atmos content, and you're buying a soundbar which is just two channel, then you're not really going to do justice in terms of the virtual surround sound experience. You need to buy a soundbar which has got HDMI EARC so that you get the Atmos effect from the soundbar which your TV can actually pass on to. So that's the reason these five questions will actually help you with the right soundbar that you need for your TV or for your application. So once again, to sum up, you have to remember to ask yourself these five questions. The first one, what is the application? Do you just want to amplify the TV sound, or do you need a virtual surround sound experience? The second question is, what is the room size wherein you are going to install this soundbar? The third question is, what is your TV size that to which your soundbar is going to be connected? The fourth question is, what is the placement option of the soundbar? The fifth question is, what sort of inputs are you going to actually connect to this soundbar or to your TV, and how are you going to fetch out the audio output from your TV? So these five questions will help you understand the right soundbar that you should invest into. And I am going to give you a bonus tip out here. Now, I know for a fact that a soundbar has got multiple drivers, but it lacks in the low frequency department, which is your bass department. So that's why if you need more bass, make sure to identify the models which comes with wireless subwoofer along. If not, make sure to have an RCA port to your subwoofer so that you can connect any third party active subwoofer to your soundbar. So with these questions, I hope that you all can find the right approach or the right way to identify the perfect soundbar for your application, and you do not make mistakes, obviously, or regret that, okay, I must have, you know, bought a wrong soundbar, or I should have bought this versus this. So I hope that this video helps you out with that. For those of you who need to confirm, or you who need to know the best soundbars of 2021, make sure to watch the video which I'm going to share after this particular video, so that you can identify one of those models as well, if that makes your life easy. And to those of you who have got more queries, feel free to use the T20 services which are shared in the description below, wherein you and I can connect for 20 minutes and I can help you with the right product, right price, and the right connection method. That's it from my end, guys. I, Tanmay Mehta, your home technology consultant from Touchwood Automations, will see you all in my next video. Thank you.